Karens, they know no bounds on what stupid things they end up doing and how much they decide to harass the local Walmart manager. Purely because they're not happy that this certain item that they were here to grab is out of stock, and unfortunately, no one can help her deal with that because there's no stores with it. Unfortunate for you, Karen. Welcome back to Completely Stupid, the show about stupid people doing completely stupid things. I'm the Aussie Idiot, as you know. Let's get into the stupid clips, eh? This Karen is causing issues at the local Walmart and is apparently also a nurse, so that's fun to know, I suppose.
What?
Do you have a medical issue?
Yes.
What's your medical issue?
It's none of your business.
Well, I'm a nurse. I'm just wondering if you're unbelievably rude.
Yeah, I feel that's how I'm not.
Have you had a stroke? Because at least that didn't work sense. No, I'm being straight.
Are they still down, Rachel?
I want you to call a manager up here.
Rachel, a woman wants to speak with a manager.
Much nicer with Rachel.
Yes, because that's what the world needs. More people who just diagnose other people by simply looking at them and assuming they have some form of medical issues because of how they act in as a person. Yeah, that makes 110% sense. Also, I don't know how I would be feeling if I was that old lady still working at Walmart. Maybe she enjoys the job. I mean, she might. I won't knock her for it. It's just interesting to see someone who looks old still be at Walmart and has to deal with people like this nurse. They're great, aren't they? These Karens are fun. Here we listen into an interesting conversation between an employer and the employee, which ultimately leads after the fact for other reasons to this guy resigning.
What are your hours?
Ms. Hoffman, the fire people that was here this morning,
Jonathan,
was outside. They had to get
Jonathan,
in the building.
Stop talking. What are your hours?
My hours is from 6:30 to 3 o'clock.
Okay. Why did you leave today at 2:45?
I didn't leave at 2:45.
You did.
I did not leave at 2:45.
We were calling you.
When I left,
What time do you think you left?
When I left, when I was
what
leaving at that
do
door.
What time do you think you left?
When I was leaving at that door,
what
it was
what time
2
do you think you left?
52 when I was going out that door.
Because you left early.
I didn't leave early because I was here early.
What time do you work till? What are your hours?
Ms. Hoffman,
the fire people
that was here this morning,
Jonathan,
was outside. They had to get
Jonathan,
in the building.
Stop talking. The building is not open until 6:30. You don't adjust your hours just because you feel like it.
I didn't do it because I felt like it, Ms. Hoffman. I was
you
doing
did
it to help the fire people
who
to get inside the building.
Who told you to open the building early? Did your boss, Susan Opperman, tell you to start your hours early today?
I was not supposed to start my hours early today, but like I was
but
telling
nothing
you, the fire people had to get inside. They were sitting
who
out there for
boss
almost an hour.
Who is your boss? Is your boss Susan Opperman or the fire marshal? Who is your boss?
Ms. Hoffman, you're my boss. I never
so
said you
hours
was my boss. I explained my hours
6:30 to
you.
6:30 to 3.
Yes.
Jonathan, if you left before 3 o'clock, you left early. You left before your shift was done.
So let me explain this to you. From yesterday when we had the meeting, I didn't get out of here until 3:15.
Why?
Because you had us in the meeting.
No, I finished on time.
No, it was not. When
yes,
I left out that
I,
door,
I finished,
that's the time, that, that's
I
the time I left
on
out
time
that door
yesterday.
Okay.
I did. I made it a point to finish on time yesterday because I do not want to keep you past your hours.
It was when I left out the building, Ms. Hoffman, it was past 3 o'clock.
I don't know what you were doing between when you left that room at 3 o'clock to when you left this building.
I didn't get fired. I was forced to resign. Again, I did not get fired. I was forced to resign. And why I was forced to resign was not because of that video. That video led up to what they was trying to do from the beginning. And what that was trying to get me out the door for their own personal reasons. You know, it was wrong how they did it. You know, I was thinking that being that I was going to resign, that I was be able to, you know, get back into the system. But that didn't happen. You know, I was tricked. And when I tried to get back into the system, my application kept being denied, wasn't getting any interviews. I called to HR, spoke with the director, Northside, and she told me, her name was Patty, she told me straight like this, you know, you no longer can be an employee of Fulton County.
Coming from the perspective of someone who lives in a country where the worker rights are actually somewhat bolstered, it's very interesting just hearing how this situation unfolded. I mean, it's one of those things in general where even if you get forced to resign, it should be one of those things where you should try to avoid or talk to other people about, like, at least here in this country, most places tend to have a union unless you're in a small business and you might not be as lucky. But usually you're told, hey, like, usually the advice is go talk to your local union manager, get advice from them, figure out where the next approach is going, and figure out things from there. There's a thing down here in Australia called fair work, which basically, if let's say you get an unfair dismissal, you can take your previous employer, like, you can take this to fair work. Fair work will dig into this and then take your previous employer to court if they feel like that the employer did some wrongdoing. And they can ultimately provide you various different things, whether it be giving your position back if you so choose that, or various other means of compensation, something along the example of upwards of 6 months worth of your pay paid out. It's a very interesting scene how things work, how some people get to deal with work in America, coming from the perspective of someone who's in a far different country that tends to care a lot more about the general worker's right. Here we have a very interesting clip. I don't really have too much to say in the preemptive of it. Basically, there seems to be some issues that have occurred prior to this recording here between the employee and the person recording, and ultimately escalates in the employee snatching the customer's debit card and rolling into this clip here.
I need my card. Oh, they on the way, don't worry. I just want to show y'all, this is the lady, McDonald's, this is who represent you guys. This is the lady representing, but it's on my car, it's not on you. If I threw sauce on you, how is it on me? Exactly, that's all we need. And she stole my car. She's a worker at McDonald's and she got my card. She got my card. And you're gonna lose your job, sweetheart. You're gonna lose your job. You need your $7.50. You're gonna lose your job. Hey, you're gonna need it. Whatever it is, you're gonna need it. You're gonna need it, sweetheart. I don't. You're gonna need it. I don't. Do you see she's so aggressive? Oh my gosh, I feel so bad for my life. Because you stole my car. Look, oh my gosh. Michelle, I think her name is Michelle. Oh my gosh. You had, oh my gosh, you see? McDonald's, these are the people that you're employing. She has stole my debit card. She plans on you. Yeah, she took it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for admitting that you stole my debit card. Artie Hammer. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You stole it. Oh my gosh, you stole it. She took it. That's it. That's theft. That's theft, Michelle. You're going to jail. You're going to jail. You're going to jail, sweetheart. You're going to jail. No, I'm waiting. I'm waiting on the police. I'm waiting on the police. I'll call the police. I got more to lose than you, sweetheart. You work at McDonald's. You working at McDonald's.
I can take a picture, put it on Facebook, got shit gone.
No, it's not really. It's a prepaid card. Go ahead. Break it, sweetheart.
She in my window.
Break it. What is your corporate name? What's your corporate manager name? Where is the corporate information? I need your corporate information. Go get my other phone.
I got to come back up here tomorrow.
I'm suing McDonald's because they hire people like you. You're very aggressive. You got barbecue sauce all on me. You're very aggressive. You were aggressive from the beginning. All I said was I needed to ring up two. No, I didn't. I said I needed two fries. No, I know. Because I'm suing you guys.
Yeah,
I'm suing you, Michelle, because I'm suing McDonald's. You stole my card, like you said on camera. You took something. You took my debit card. You said you're gonna take it and put it on Facebook. So, yes, I'm definitely. This is just my evidence to see what kind of employees they hire to represent their company. To know that they represent you, they got people representing your company. And I'm glad it's on camera. Cause you're the one in the wrong. You finna lose your job, sweetheart. You are finna lose your job.
I would be surprised if the employee kept their job in any way, shape, or form. Even prior to the whole debit card stealing thingamabob of the entire piece here. I know from secondhand experience because I know people who work for McDonald's here in Australia. And even down here in Australia, they're very, very heavy on the discipline. Like, hey, you need to learn to be calm around customers. And if you can't handle them at that point in time, you need to step away and not get in a fight with them. Clearly, she's not doing that here. She's going off her nutters and even stole a customer's credit card and then threatened to take photos of it to throw on the internet so people can use up all her money. Like, that just is... I don't think there's anything worse for your career in just general than doing something along these lines, because you could assume that not only would you get terminated by McDonald's here from this situation, you possibly might get sued, maybe, I don't know. The customer behind the camera might not end up doing that, and I don't know. It doesn't seem like that'd be the case, though, so... good luck with that one. But also, that would be permanent markings onto your actual career, because, you know, 9 times out of 10, your next people you try to get apply for a job to will always attempt to contact your previous employer. And, well, unless you choose to just pretend that you never got employed at McDonald's in the first place, this information of what you did here and why you lost this job is definitely not going to look good for you in the long run. So, good job. You made the wisest of wise decisions here. And by wise, I mean completely stupid. In this clip, we got a Karen who was caught attempting to break into a car, apparently. Though, I'm honestly a little perplexed on how the hell this has even happened in the first place. Like, there seems to be... you know, just watch the clip first and I'll get back to you on this in a moment.
Told me that I could use this car because my car broke down. I'm so sorry. Is this not my car?
What are you doing? What is this?
Look, these were all in here, and this is
my car.
Okay, I'm sorry, dude. I did not know that this was your car. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Okay, just dip.
Okay.
Goodbye. Don't touch nothing else. You're lucky I don't have my mom come out here. What are you doing?
I got my purse right here.
I don't give a.
Look, can I just get my purse?
No, you ain't getting. Look,
I'm so
this
sorry.
This is my.
I will call my friend right now.
I don't care. Get out of here.
Look,
call the police.
I'm so
call
sorry.
Call the police. Call the police.
Just let me get my purse.
Get
my purse.
Get out of my vehicle.
Look, I'm not trying to steal anything.
Just throw her. Let her just throw it across.
Look, I'm not trying to cause any problems to anybody or anything.
Okay, just stop talking. I'm trying to tell him to just stop talking.
If I would have known that this was an issue, I would never have came out here. I was out here during the day.
Okay. Well,
I never would have known.
I never seen that stuff before.
This is just clothes and my boyfriend's medication. I'm so sorry. Like, I'm not.
You're out here breaking my column down and shit.
I'm already like that. I don't even know how to do that. Dude.
I heard you out here starting it. Get out of here. Get out of here. No.
There's medicine
Dad.
In
I don't care.
Dad.
No.
Dad.
No.
Dad, just throw her.
If I would have known.
Take your mask down.
No, sir.
Take your mask down.
No, sir.
I'll give it to you. Take your mask
down. I'm sorry, but there's a few red flags that are immediately going off in my head in this clip. Either the car was unlocked, so the person didn't question anything about it, or B, she actually broke into a car, but is that off her, I'm sorry. I'm trying to make sense of this entire thing. Like, considering the fact that right at the back end of the clip, she decided to whip her mask down, and then I'm assuming beyond the clip itself, they just resolve it and move on with their time. Like, I'm sorry, I'm just so lost in what even happened here. Okay, so your friend told you, hey, you can use this car for the night because your car's broken down, the car's unlocked. Like, how did you start it? Did you hotwire it? Did you get told to hotwire it? Did you not get given the keys to borrow the car? Like, I'm just so lost in what even is this? Like, there's just multi layers of what even happened here. You do better. Here we have a manager who's not quite happy with the fact that a customer may or may not have slightly messed up one of the items on the shelves and decide to go up to them when they're being served, yell at them, and then order them to get out.
Penny items. Are you going to go and fix them?
Yes, show me where they are. Show me which ones.
You know what? You get out now. You came and yelled at us.
Customers?
No.
We just came to buy something.
Void it out. Get
no,
out.
We're going to buy our stuff.
I said,
you
no.
Can't re-
get
you
out.
Cannot deny
you're not going to void.
You came here yelling at us. You came here yelling at us.
You came to us. You didn't even need to come over here. She was taking care of us. You came here trying to start stuff with us.
Really? I saw you.
I show me. I want to see which ones. I want to see which ones we messed up.
What did I say?
I want to see which ones we messed up.
I want you out. You can call whoever you want. I want you out.
And that's what we do. On Saturday, we go to every single store and we never have no one, whatever you are, general manager, whatever, no one ever treats us like that. Do you understand?
Guess what?
We've gone to five stores.
So why didn't you fix it?
It's you treat simple. People, you treat customers with respect.
Yeah, him raising his voice at me.
You came at us.
Okay, leave the store. I'm not going to argue. You can call whoever you want. I want you. They are not to walk into the store again.
I
want to
see where we messed up. Yeah, I'm going to go to the carpets. Because they look perfect.
Okay, call them.
I want you out.
Call the cops.
I'm training her. I want you out.
Call
That's
the cops.
I'm explaining to her. I'm going to do
You're
that.
Training her? And she was... scanning everything, trying to get the cans together,
really?
And you came yelling?
I want you out.
Yes, really. Really?
I want you out of the store.
Really?
Now.
Really?
And you can go wherever you want.
Really?
Anybody.
You want us out?
You already know my name. Out.
Now, you may have already noticed with the most of this video so far that I'm a little bit more defensive when it comes to most retail workers, but this one, they've got nothing for you. I'm sorry, but you see a customer slightly mess up a shelf, you don't just go up to the customer, go off at them for doing it. That's just dumb and stupid. You just fix it up a little and move on with your day, because many customers will do exactly that. I mean, there's literally the toy section of most supermarkets are always a complete and utter mess, because kids will just make a mess of the section there. There's no need to go off at a customer for doing that. You just either pretend, move on, don't worry about it, or fix up the issue and then move on. You don't go and argue against the customer for slightly messing up something in the store that might have even done by accident. Like, that's just stupid. I'm sorry, but the manager here is just wholeheartedly in the wrong. I got nothing for it. Here we have a pair of Karens fighting with a hostess on a plane.
Our first time flying Spirit, and this happened.
Bitch, you gonna be sitting in there. Bitch, you probably not.
All right, everybody, if you want to reunite with your luggage, you can claim it at Carousel.
From the sounds of the announcement at the end of that clip, it turns out they're at the end of the flight. Like, you couldn't have just waited, like, the 5 to 10 minutes it takes to get off the plane and then move on with your day. You just had to go off at the flight host there just for some forsaken reason. Like, you couldn't have just held on a moment. Like, there's potentiality there might have been some racist interaction there. I'm not 100% sure, because it gets a bit heated when those two women who were sitting down start responding very aggressively. I'm not 100% sure, but it's still one of those things. You're literally at the end of the flight. Why do you need to be like this now? It's like, you could have just
moved on, not worried about it. You're about to get off the plane anyway and probably never see this person again. Here we have yet another angry worker going off of the customers because they took too long to think of an order. Okay, here's what happens. You're not you when you're hungry, so have a Mars bar. Maybe you'll be a little bit happier. That's such a bad joke. So we got a Karen going through all seven stages of grief.
I'm so excited to meet my first real life Karen.
Right here.
Yeah, yeah.
Right here.
What's going on?
This is a Chelsea.
Okay.
Chelsea Handler.
I get to, is she joking or is this serious?
No, I'm serious. I'm serious as a fucking heart attack, you rotten bastard.
What's going on?
I'm serious as a f***ing heart attack!
Yeah, yeah. Serious about what?
How long to take?
What are you talking about?
How long to take?
How long to what take?
How long to take to get the schlack in your food?
What does that mean?
How about your bartenders? What? Are they all women?
I have no idea. I don't work here.
Who named it?
Not me.
What happened to the restaurant before it was here?
Obviously, they didn't make it.
They didn't make it?
It seems that way. If they're not here. Noah's? I'm sorry?
You going to Noah's today?
What is Noah's?
Noah's in Stonington?
I don't live around here.
You don't even know Noah's.
I live in Scituate.
I just can't do this anymore. It's too much fun. Right here.
You got
hey, you two.
Any more? Ah,
I'm
there
like,
it is.
Your channel,
all right, awesome.
Did you get to Chelsea?
Who's Chelsea?
Chelsea Handler.
What about her?
I don't know. She's a fucking rich bitch that's really loony that loves to speak her mind.
This looks like you're missing just the rich part, huh?
Are you Greek?
Am I what?
Are you Greek?
Am I Greek?
Yeah.
No, I don't have enough hair to be Greek. Oh, you're going to regard me now? All right.
That's smelling really good. There you go. Fucking make sure she's a chef. How about that? Never did that.
All right, hey, it's
not a million years have I ever done that?
Oh, man, every time I think you're done, you just step it up a bit.
Not a million years
right.
Have I ever put shellac in someone's food. You
right.
Got that, you
Woo, you're going to have a heart attack.
I don't even believe what I'm
I hope you do enough cardio.
No, I don't. You want to see my tummy too?
No, it's clearly.
I was told I look like shit at the beach.
Well, it makes
or
sense.
I would look like shit at the beach.
All right, I gotta get back to work. Hey, this has been great. I was super excited for this.
Making?
Thank you so much.
This is so funny. I just love the guy's energy in this clip. He's just like, oh my god, I get to record a Karen. Look at me go. Mom and dad, look at me now. It's so funny. But the lady here is just... I don't even know what's even happening here. It just looks like she's going through multiple stages of different feelings and all that, and then ultimately ends at a point... I don't get it. She goes from just being like, oh yeah, I'm serious, I'm having fun with this, to just screaming her head off for some reason or other. In this next clip, we got a Karen who's loud enough to be understood.
Program, not the city, babe. It is not illegal to yell here. Excuse me, ma'am. You are helped when you are visiting the city. Would you please ask your family to correct it? You have been fired and sued several times. I will not leave your bullshit store. You have been asked very loudly about your family's contracts. You do not live off this salary. Goodbye, with the understanding I asked quietly and it is not illegal to be loud.
Get the fuck out, lady.
Fuck out. Look at the grown-ass California asshole that can't afford to pass
for
you.
Great victory for the people, man. Goodbye.
Well, I mean, at least I can understand what the hell you're trying to go on about, but it still confuses me. Or this contract that you're under, your family's contract you're under, there's no way you live with that salary, whatever the like, it genuinely perplexes me. What is her thought process on that entire thing? What, like, from what I can gather, what does it fucking matter to you on how much another person earns in a different job that is no way in relation to you? You're literally just a customer. And yes, it's not illegal to yell, it's very, very disrespectful, and then slamming your hands on other people's property, that is potentially illegal, especially if you do end up causing some possible damage. Lie. In this next clip, we've got a very interesting confrontation between a worker and a customer at a fast food restaurant.
Huh? She's got the train. I mean, when she has everything right on the screen, she's got to say, no, nobody asked if everything was right on the screen. I ordered chicken tacos. And I double checked when I got to the window. No, I'm not going to calm down.
I got it.
You don't understand. You don't. I really you don't understand how serious this is.
I understand that. You don't understand that.
Huh? I didn't ask you to come over here.
I just asked for my manager.
I'm being very rude. Motherfucker! Come on, come on.
Alex, I need you to step back.
No. Come on.
And I need Valerie.
I need you to throw it to the back. You can't say things like that.
You didn't come over to help me out, buddy. No, you didn't.
Now, I'm not 100% sure what precisely happened in this clip. I'm going to guess off of what we do here that the order was incorrect, which then leads me to the second thing. Wait a minute, did this guy go through the drive-thru, get his order, and then when he realized something was wrong, instead of sitting in the drive-thru causing a ruckus that way, he parked and got out of his car and went inside to get things fixed? Oh my god, is the human race starting to heal a little bit? Like, I swear, I just did a 40-minute video the other day where I just watched so many people just stop in the middle of drive-thrus and cause a lot of mess. This guy actually has some form of human decency. Good God. Here we got a Karen who gets herself kicked out of a nail salon and absolutely loses it when she does. Here's what happened.
Go ahead. I'm not leaving until you fix my nails. And I think everybody here would agree, right? So you took my nails off?
No.
Oh, you don't agree? You don't agree. Okay, so you took my nails off. What am I supposed to do now?
You can have another professional help you at a different
salon. I can have another professional. Oh, that's real professional, yes. Sister.
Yes.
That is real. Where are you from?
Why are you? Are you worried? Why
no,
are you so
I'm
worried?
I'm not worried. Why do you come to this country, work here, and don't do what's right for our citizens? You make money, you live in my country, and you're going to tell me you can't do my nails, bitch? The fuck do you think you are, bitch? The fuck is wrong with you?
You?
Go back to your fucking country.
You should leave.
Yeah, bitch. Make me leave. Meet me outside. Catch me outside. How about that? I'm crazy as fuck. I will fucking fuck you up.
Ma'am.
Catch me outside. How about that? Bitch.
I'm not even going to say anything.
You're not going to say anything to me? Bitch, I'm smarter than any of y'all. As a matter of fact, bitch, I'm an independent artist, recording artist, and I'm going to fucking blow the fuck up. And you're gonna want me to come here and get my nails done. Check me out, Karina Monica. Stay flossy, bitch. Stay flossy. Look it up. Karina Monica, stay flossy. Because you know what? That bitch ain't flossy. This place ain't flossy. I don't want my nails in here. Y'all stop. So f*** you and get the f*** out of the house. It's hilarious, right? F*** you, bitch. Hope you fucking lose this place and you go the f*** back to your country.
If she's so smart, then why didn't she know how to do her nails?
There are many layers to unfold about this one. So first off, using a quote from what was 3 years ago, the recording of this clip is just ridiculously stupid, hoping that it would accrue the same kind of attention that it did for Bad Barbie or whatever the hell her name was back on Dr. Phil all those years ago. No, not this time around. And yes, she does have a Spotify with one monthly listener several years later. She hasn't released a song on that Spotify since 2021. And there's no song that's got more than 1,000 streams. But here's some more funny things. So just for a little bit of funny information, ironically, whilst no one knows the identity of the nail technician, it's known that she was born in the United States, whilst Monica, the Karen who's being very racist here, is from Romania and moved to America at the age of 9. Maybe you should go back to your country. That's bad. She's already in her country, Monica, you f***ing idiot. Wow, it's so funny looking into some of these incidents just for a little bit of extra things. It's just so wild. She was forced to make some form of apology on social media because, you know, this was highly racist. Oh, that was ridiculous. Here we have another elderly Karen who doesn't like people fishing.
Because why? Because of why?
I'm waiting
because,
for somebody
because
to
why?
Show up.
Why? What did we do?
Because the fishing poles are not supposed to be perched along the river edge.
Who says? Who said that? Because we've been coming here for years and we always do that. We've never, there's so many people that do that. Why are you giving me a look? We've been coming here for years. And we've never had a problem. We've never had a problem. But you want to come and make a problem when we're just, yeah. Because you have no life, right? No life? No life?
Yeah, I got a life.
No, you don't. Obviously, you don't. If you're coming over here messing with people that aren't doing nothing wrong, chilling with their kids, trying to fish, have a good time, quiet. There's a kid right there. Are you serious? Are you serious? Laugh. It's funny, isn't it? No, because I'm sick and tired of you people coming and bugging for no reason. Mind your business. Are we hurting anyone? Were you guys loud? Were you guys loud? Were you guys doing anything wrong? Yeah, because I'm sick and tired of people like you not minding your business. Mind your business. Why can't you just mind your business?
I want the fish hook.
Okay, did you guys take it out? Did you guys take it out? Okay, they took it out. So what's the problem now?
Okay, leave.
What's the problem? No! This is my family. Are you serious?
We rent.
Yeah.
So do
how
I.
Much? Okay, then get out of here.
No, I rent here.
That's wonderful. So do we.
Okay, goodbye.
So you're so upset that people are fishing
no,
at a fishing
are.
Place? No, I'm upset for people like you
no.
not minding your business. Mind your business. What is wrong with you? What is wrong with you right now? Mind your business. Leave us alone.
I am.
No, you're not. No, you're not. Leave us, yeah. You think this is funny because you have no life. You have no life. Are you intoxicated right now?
No.
Are you drunk? Because only drunk people would do this. Only drunk people would do this.
You're coming up with an excuse? Yeah.
What, that you're drunk? You're drunk.
No, I am not.
Okay, then you need to get away from us. Like, get away.
From me.
We were
I'm too damn old to fight.
Then why are you doing this?
Because
then
I hate
they took it out. They took it out. So what's the problem?
So leave me alone.
You're in our area that we were fishing in.
No, I'm
you leave. Okay, then go walk your dog then. Go walk your dog. Have a good night. Have a good night. We did, ma'am. They're gone. They're gone. What is your problem now? Yeah, shut up.
You're causing
go. Bye. Have a wonderful night. Have a wonderful night. Have a bless you. Bless your heart.
Why don't you just leave me alone now? You've done what I wanted you to do, and I don't want to walk away just yet. I want to keep standing in this general area, so I won't leave. You must leave me first, because that's how this all works. What type of self-entitlement is that? Like, what type of self-entitlement does one have to just be like, no, you leave me alone. I bothered you first, now you've got to leave me alone first. Not the other way around, which is just the stupidest, dumbest, and densest logic I've ever heard.